Mr. Tarrou. Last example of graph and a rational function. I've done one so far with a slant asymptote. I've done one so far with a horizontal and vertical asymptote. And this one particularly is going to have a lot going on with it. Now, I need to go back and add a voice bubble into the video that I did with the slant asymptote, because I kind of just sort of matter-of-factly said, when the denominator equals zero, you have a vertical asymptote. And with that example, it did. And it wasn't until the end of the video where I kind of talked a little bit about holes. Every time the denominator equals zero, you actually do not have, or does not guarantee that you have a vertical asymptote. So you might be asked to graph this. Don't be too anxious and go, okay, vertical asymptotes. Those are when the denominator equals zero. Okay, so I'm going to do x squared plus x minus 12 equals zero. And I'm going to factor that out. X plus 4 times x minus 3 equals zero. And boom, I have a vertical asymptote at, slow down a little bit. Most of the time when the denominator equals zero, you have a vertical asymptote, but not every time. In this particular case, this polynomial, I got a polynomial up here that can be factored. I got a polynomial on the bottom of a rational function that can be factored. And, well, let's do that and see what happens for a second. The top is 5x plus 20. These both can be divided by 5. So that's 5 times x plus 4 over the trinomial on the bottom of this rational function, the denominator, x squared plus x minus 12. Are there factors of 12 that subtract to be positive 1? Yes, there is, 4 and 3. So the bottom becomes x plus 4 times x minus 3. So see, I needed to factor the bottom anyway, so this was not a total waste of time, but this factor of x plus 4 cancels out. So for the rest of the problem, I'm actually going to be paying attention to graphing 5 over x minus 3. But I'm not graphing 5 over x minus 3. I'm graphing this rational function. Well, this rational function is undefined in two different places. It is undefined, x cannot equal negative 4, and x cannot equal 3. But I'm not just finding the vertical asymptotes, I'm finding out where the vertical asymptotes are, or where there's a hole in the graph. And this is going to be a hole because the x plus 4 factor cancels out, whereas the x minus 3 factor, that 0 in the denominator did not cancel away. So at x equals 3, we are going to have that vertical asymptote that I was looking for. So hopefully you can see the colors here. X equals negative 4 is a hole, and x equals 3 is going to be my vertical asymptote. Okay, let's take a look at horizontal asymptotes. Okay, when the top degree has a small, the numerator's degree, when that numerator's degree is smaller than the denominator's degree, this has a degree of 0, this has a degree of 1, or this has a degree of 1 and this has a degree of 2. If your bottom degree is larger than your top degree, then your horizontal asymptote is going to be y equals 0. Great. All right. What's the next thing we're concerned with when we do graphing of rational functions? Well, x-intercepts. That's where y equals 0. Well, when you have a rational function, to make that rational function equal 0, if the bottom equals 0, it's undefined. If the top equals 0, then you have an x-intercept. But the top of this rational function is a constant. The top of this rational function is 5. So there's no way for me to make 5 equal to 0. That's just simply not going to happen. So there is not going to be an x-intercept for this function. Great. Now moving on. What else could we possibly have? Well, what about a y-intercept? That's when x equals 0. I might not have any room to draw my graph after I'm done filling all this up. Well, let's see. Let's let x equal 0. Whether you do it here or here with the reduced function, it won't make any difference. The y-intercept is going to be 5 over 0 minus 3, or the y-intercept is going to be equal to negative 5 thirds. All right. Is the function even or odd? If I plug in f of negative x, I get, well, let's do the reduced function. 5 over negative x minus 3. If every single sign had stayed the same, it would be even, and that's not the case. Why do I care about it being even? It would be symmetric to the y-axis. It'd be a mirror image, and it'd be easier to draw. If every sign changed, but it does not, then it would be odd. Why would I care about that? Because that would tell me that it has 180 degree rotational symmetry, which it does not. So I'm kind of like done, except for trying to fill in the rest of the information when I have this, when I try and draw my graph. So what do I got? I've got, so far, I can draw an xy axis. I can draw a vertical asymptote. I can draw a vertical asymptote at x equals 3. So at x equals 3, there's a vertical asymptote. I can draw a horizontal asymptote at y equals 0. And I have a y-intercept of negative 5 thirds. So that's about negative, just under negative 2. So right there. Wow. I've done a lot of work to learn one point. Okay, so we need a table of values to finish this up, and I need more room. So I'm going to get rid of this, and I'm going to make a t-table of values using the values of 0, 1, and 2. Well, actually, I already know what it is at 0. So why don't we do 1 and 2 and negative 1. Negative 1, 1 and 2. And I'm also going to use x values of 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And I'll probably have to approximate some decimals here, but that's okay. So negative 1, 5 over negative 1 minus 3. Negative 1 minus 3 is negative 4. So that's negative 5 fourths. At 1, we're at 5 over 1 minus 3. That's 5 over 1 minus 3 is negative 2. And now at 2, we're at 5 over 2 minus 3. So that's negative 1. So we're at 5 over negative 1. And what happens when we get past or the other side of the asymptote at 4 and 5 and so on? Well, if I plug in 4, it's 5 over 4 minus 3. Well, 4 minus 3 is 1. So that's 5, and if I plug in 5, that's 5 over 5 minus 3, which is 2, so it's 5 over 2. I'm starting to kind of get a repeat of values, so if it was placed differently, it might have been odd, but it wasn't. So negative 1, negative 5 fourths, so a little bit less than negative 1. At 1, we're at negative 5 halves, 5 divided by 2 is 2.5, so it's negative 2 and a half. And at 3, we're at negative 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you can see the curve happening here, and it's going to approach underneath the bottom of the asymptote. You can occasionally go through a horizontal asymptote, by the way. You might occasionally go up over it and then approach it from the top. That generally happens fairly quickly, though, or near the vertical asymptotes, generally. And over here at 4, we're at 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, we're at 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And at 5, we're at 5 halves, or 5 divided by 2 is 2.5. So at 5, we're at 2.5. And we're going to get a graph that comes down and curves off the screen. And voila, we have made, oops, ooh, ooh, whoa. What did I almost forget? I almost said bam and went home. There is a hole at -4. Whoa, I mean, I'm like teaching this stuff and I almost forget. Now, I don't care if you have a T81, which is ancient, T82, T83, T84, or if you just spent $100 on a $150 on a TI Inspire CX Cast that was 150 bucks. This, you know, except for I ran off the screen, this is the graph you would see until you pull up the table of values. And when you get to x equals -4, you're going to have a problem, or at least it'll identify the hole for you. At x equals -4, now, okay, see, I just spent all this time graphing 5 over x minus 3, but I'm not graphing this function, I'm graphing this function. Well, this function is undefined at -4, so 1, 2, 3, 4. -4, I'm going to come in here, I'm going to erase part of that line, I'm going to show my teacher I didn't just copy that graph off my calculator and identify that hole, and now I'm done! Have a great weekend!
Or just do your homework, but this is my weekend.